Welcome back, everyone. Let's talk about the factory pattern and a little bit correction from the last video. In the last video, I was just creating the say hello functions and try to execute the say hello dot something like this, right? But this is wrong, right? I'm calling directly from the function. It is not if you block. So obviously you need to create an object first for this particular say hello functions. Now I can just say x.cHello, and if you, this is the right way, right? And if you don't want it to do that, then you need to create a if block. How we can do that? Var if block equal to cHello equal to function. So let's create it in the if block. What happened? Function, yeah, this is now if you lock, and you can call it, because say hello is now an object itself. You can call say hi method on top of it and it will give you the value 80. Okay, I'll leave it. Now next thing which we are going to talk about is the factory pattern. Factory is an industrial term, and what a factory pattern is used everywhere and what it do. Okay, I have the machine factory where you give me the type. Okay, you are giving me the type of printer, I will give you the instance of printer. If you are giving me the type as a motherboard, I will give you the instance of motherboard. If you are giving me the type as computer, I will give you the personal computer. If you are giving me the laptop, I will give you the laptop. So this is all about the factory pattern. What we have is a class or a function that's called a machine factory. Machine factory is the class, I'm not creating function. And here, what we are doing, creating machine. This is the method we have. Let's use the camel case in here. Create machine is a method I'm doing. So here, I will be accepting a type or the options. Okay, so here, I can create a switch block or if block. What I will do, options dot type. You might be passing with the type. It's a triple equals, and type is like car, type is like computer. What I will give you. So this factory function will be responsible for giving you the instance of that particular type. All right, letter new computer, right? If you are giving me, let's put it as a if I else if. If you are giving me laptop, I will give you the instance of laptop. Otherwise, if nothing is matching, obviously I need to see something, right? Else return what you see, keyboard. Okay, so what are these? Computer, laptop. These will be the separate classes out there. Class is computer. This will be another class. Class laptop will be another class. I'm not creating the further definition of those classes, but it's understood it. You might have a lot of other things in the computer and laptop and these keyboard classes, but the factory function is give you the object of that what you need. That's it. This is all about the factory. Now in this computer, you can have the constructor which is saying something else, where you are setting some parameters like options is here, and in the options you are setting something like this dot type, right? Computer type is the brand, company type and all. So options dot type. Otherwise what I will set, I will set it to HP. I mean, these are just random, this dot configuration, right, of the laptop. If this is that, otherwise I will set it to i5 octa-core or something. Okay, leave about it. So this is all about the factory pattern which we use in our daily life, and this is extensive. We use it extensively in our application. That's it. In the next video, we'll talk about observer and other patterns. So we actually divided all these categories into the creational, behavioral, and these are different broad categories, but I'm not going to talk about these fancy names. I will talk about only in terms of JavaScript. This is the factory pattern. There may be a command pattern, observer pattern, proto pattern, prototype pattern, revealing pattern, singleton pattern, adapter pattern, or iterator pattern. Only those which we see in the JavaScript code.